the nursery, primary to secondary school level. Ghana has one of the best education systems.
Everybody knows the way they cause wahala. Every time when we step in the place, everybody see us, them just the holla.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Vanessa, and today we have a special guest on our channel. This is Jazz Teller. Yes, he has decided this is where he wants to be. Ignore him. He's our special guest today. Today we are going to be talking about 5 reasons why you should consider relocating to Ghana. Before we get into all of that, if this is your first time on my channel and you're just seeing my face for the first time, please don't forget to subscribe before you leave. And if you are a returning subscriber, thank you for coming back. Thank you for always you mean a lot to me. And before you leave us, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, comment your honest opinion in the comment section. Also, and share my channel also, and let's get straight into today's video. So today we're talking about 5 reasons why you should consider relocating to Ghana in 2021. Yeah, I know often when you ask people, oh, why do you love Ghana, or why do you love living in Ghana, or are you considering moving to Ghana, you hear things like because of the food, because of the culture, you hear things like because of the weather, the food, the beaches they have lots of amazing beaches in Ghana. Beaches like beaches, I don't know, pardon all of that. They have lots of amazing resorts here in Ghana, and then there is the culture that's very rich, and then there is a working democracy here in Ghana also. So when you ask people, oh, of all of Africa, why are you considering locating to Ghana when there are other countries in Africa, these are one of the things you often hear. And all of these are actually true. The food in Ghana is top notch, and the culture in Ghana, I love how in touch they are with their culture. Like, Ghana is becoming one of the most developed countries in Africa right now, but somehow they are still very much in touch with their culture, unlike some countries where they become so westernized that they actually, I think they forego and they let go of their culture. And the only this is where you see their culture is some of these villages where they place some orphans in, they place some people in, and they made to look extremely poor, where to attract white tourists to come and have photo ops. Just what is it? Have photo ops with some of these children. That is the where they still show this archaic tradition, and I don't know what how to call it. I will put some of those pictures of the things I'm talking about here. Yeah, I think it's okay to showcase your culture, but I think some of this, it was only last year that I realized that there are some of these villages in some of these African countries, they are being put in place just for foreigners to come and have photo ops with the idea of Africa they have in the Western world. Only last year that I realized that things like that happen in Africa, that there are villages like that that have put in place, that there are some big men who take payments for foreigners to go there. That's the kind of culture I'm talking about. Like in Ghana here, you see development is happening every day. You see all of these beautiful structures, all of these roads coming up, everything. You see all of these foreigners coming in and living in Ghana. Literally, you see that the economy of Ghana is actually on the rise, and development is coming up gradually and everything. But one thing they've been able to retain is their culture. They are actually very big on their culture, which is one of the reasons I love Ghana. I love living in Ghana because I am very big on culture. Like, I'm Nigerian. Wow, I'm an Isoko girl. I will not ever go to somewhere else and identify like just a black girl, or just want to be Western. I don't want to be my Isoko girl. We are big on cultures, and that's something Ghana, they're big on. You still go to places and you hear them speaking their languages, you see, you hear them six communicating to each other in their languages, their local food is still there. So yes, all of these things, people mention to you that the food, the weather, the culture, all of these, they are right. But today I'm here to give you 5 best reasons, or better reasons, why you should consider relocating to Ghana. Number one of those reasons is business and entrepreneurial opportunities for everyone. There are literally several aspects in Ghana, like the agriculture, tech industry, that literally lots of opportunities still there for all for the grabs in Ghana. Ghana is beaming with lots of business opportunities. there are lots of sectors with opportunities still up for the grab. The market in Ghana is still very much unsaturated.
There's opportunity in the agricultural sector,
agro-processing sector, in the tech sector, in the retailing sector also. There are lots of opportunities for people to still buy into here in Ghana. So for a place where you'll be able to set up in an unsaturated and emerging market, then Ghana is the place to consider. Number two, benefits. I know when I say health benefits, they always say, oh, is this girl joking? Ghana, they don't have the best healthcare system. Yes, they do not actually have the best healthcare system. I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to paint what is not. Africa, we don't really have the best healthcare system. But have you ever wondered why, despite the quality of the healthcare system in Ghana here, lots of diabetic patients, and a lot of high blood pressure, people not collapsing and dying, people not okay, their mental health, because there are mental health problems, mental health issues everywhere in the world. I'm not saying they're not, but why you don't see all of these things on the rise, where they are not lots of them, where there are literally no people just collapsing and just going into depression and wanting to do some of things. I do not want to like say out here. I don't know if it's against YouTube rules and community, that there are people literally just existing and still be able to live a healthy life in Ghana despite the situation, the condition of the healthcare system. Is the level of stress in the Western world, the stress level is on the high side. You live from check to check. Most people, they work 3 to 5 jobs just to be able to provide for themselves, to be able to live in a good house, to be able to eat, to be able to pay bills. They literally have to work around the clock. You see people working from Monday to Friday, sometimes the weekend also, working multiple hours a week just to be able to earn a living. Whereas in Ghana here, you see someone that actually do not even have one of these bougie jobs, that's not any thousands of cities, that's literally just being able to fend for themselves. They live a peaceful life, they live a quiet life, always happy. You know what thing happiness is? Happiness is something that promotes health. Personally with me, if I'm mad at something and I get very angry, I get sick, like physically sick. Like, that's why most time I try as much as possible not to be angry. When things are happening, I don't like. That's why I say I'm not a confrontational. I don't like quarreling. I don't like getting angry and stressing myself. Because if I do that, I get sick, physically sick. So when you are like happy and you are living in a peaceful environment where you do not have to kill yourself just to be able to earn a living. Literally in Ghana, yeah, you can be working your 5 to job and earning any amount of money you're earning. You're able to live a good life. In Ghana, you're happy. So because of all the reasons, you see that the high blood pressure is on the low. You see that there's no, and because there are lots of organic food being eaten here, traditional food, African food, not a lot of processed food being consumed like it is being consumed in the Western world. Where literally every of the food they are eating is usually coming from a cup or coming from one processed with a preservative and the rest. We literally zero nutrient, whereas the African food, you're eating your fufu, you're eating your you're eating your goat, you're eating your jollof, and you're eating all of those things. You have all of this nutrient. You see, we have a better health than them. So yeah, that's why I say come to Ghana for health benefit, because when you have peace of mind, when the situation is not too stressed, the country is a relaxed country, it's a happy country, people are happy, and you go outside and see people and literally happy to see you doing well, people greeting you, people talking to you, people dancing in the streets, even when you see that they don't actually have your own idea of riches. Yeah, so that's why I say consider relocating Ghana for the health thing about the relaxed system in Ghana. Yes. You're not being stressed, you're not thinking about this, you're not thinking about that. It shows on your skin, literally. You have fresh I'm joking, my skin is literally, it's mostly genetic, because my mommy has one of the best skin for a 60 something years old woman. But yeah, textures on your skin, you have a clearer skin. I see some of these African Americans that are located to Ghana, and they're using some of this shea butter. You see their skin shiny. I personally, I use Nivea. You see their skin shiny. You see, it's mostly because they're not stressing as we're stressing in outside world. And don't get me wrong, Ghana can get hot sometimes, like unbearably hot. I'm not going to say Ghana is hot. They say from Nigeria, stop saying Ghana is hot. Ghana is hot. I'm from Delta State. We are riverine area. I'm used to the cold. But all of that, notwithstanding, you can see them showing on your skin. Here is quality of life, better quality of life. I know before you start laughing and say, what do you mean better quality of life? We live in the UK, or we live in the US, or we live in the... them their own idea of first world country, and obviously apparently Africa, we are living
but here in Ghana, there's opportunity for a better quality of life. When I say better quality of life, I don't mean high standards of living.
High standard of living, I actually mean quality standard of living. And you say, okay, what's the difference between high standard of living?
Oftentimes, high standard of living, like in the Western world, is often equated with the kind of jobs you have, the kind of house you are living in, the kind of car you are driving, the amount of money you have, or how rich you are, or the vacations you are taking, and the kind of clothes you are putting on. That is oftentimes what is considered the high standard of living in the Western world. But here in Ghana, precisely in Ghana,
standard of living
is not materialistic, whereas the high standard of living is often materialistic, or is often equated with material things, like I just mentioned. But it's not.
Full time, the quality of living in Ghana,
happiness, peace of satisfaction level, is often happiness, peace of mind, satisfaction.
It's subjective.
Of course, it is a subjective.
You get the picture I am trying to paint. You get it?
And number four is the people of Ghana that are really very friendly. Number four reason why she considered relocating to Ghana in 2021, from wherever you are relocating from, is the people of Ghana are actually very friendly. The Ghanaians, they are very friendly, they are welcoming, they embrace into their community. You go out carrying out your business, people asking you, oh, how are you doing?
You ask them, how are you? Literally, the sense of community here, it's really nice. Everybody is included in the community. And I know when I say this, it triggers some people into saying, oh, I have horrible experiences with some Ghanaians. It's the same thing some of the Ghanaians do when you have horrible experience with a Nigerian, and that's supposed to be the standard of all the Nigerians. It's not like that with the Ghanaians. So because you have a horrible experience with one Ghanaian, don't mean all Ghanaians are like that. Most Ghanaians that I know are actually very friendly and actually very welcoming. And when you even try to speak the language to them, I think they like it so much. And you see, they're trying to tell you, oh, this is how they pronounce it, this is how they pronounce it. Oh, try and learn the language so you communicate better with us. I'll be like, I'm trying, you know, because I'm very horrible with languages. From the last video I made when I was talking about how friendly Ghana is, hard welcoming the ad, there's this Liberian man that came and he literally left this whole like 2 pages long comment on my video telling me about all of the horrible experiences he's had in Ghana since he's been living in Ghana, how he went home and his business was, so many things like that. And like I told him, it's the same thing I tell everybody, you have a horrible experience with some Ghanaians, don't mean all Ghanaians are like that. So yeah, I'm not going to come here and say no, because some of the Ghanaians are actually made, they're actually very friendly. Like in my estate, they are really nice to me, and I babysit children in my estate also.
It is
like
totally cool.
And then number five is the education system. If you're looking for a country that can offer you a good business opportunity, that's offering you good standard of quality standard of living, a better health system, or better health, and you are not settled, and the only thing you are looking for, like, oh, okay, since this country can give me this, can it give my child quality education? So if you are looking for a country that has all of this to offer and you still be able to provide your child one of the best quality education, then Ghana is the place you want to consider, because from their foundational level education up to their secondary school education is really very good. their standard of education. Like the children in my estate, most time when I'm talking to them about their homework, when they are back from school, I see how smart they really are, and I see how their education is really sound. So if you are looking for where, I'm just talking about from the primary to the secondary, because obviously the tertiary institution, I don't really know much about them. I don't know the quality of their education. I will not be able to speak on that. And they still mostly believe that the Western universities are better than the ones in Africa. But as for the foundational primary, the nursery, primary to secondary school level, Ghana has one of the best education systems in those areas. And the public school system is free also. If you do not have the luxury of affording the private schools in Ghana, but I don't know if it's free to everyone. I don't know if it's free to foreigners also, but I know their public school system is free. It's mostly that in Nigeria also. Most of the public schools in Nigeria, all of them basically, from the primary to the secondary school level, they are free. And if the fee that they outside will collect exam levy is usually 300 naira, that's like 3 to 4 CDs. That's what you're paying in a term of 3 months. So it's not like, so it's free. And in the one in Nigeria is actually free for everybody, foreigners and non-foreigners. But I don't know if the one in Ghana is free for everybody, but I know it is mostly free. So these are some of the things you should consider if I'm moving to Ghana in 2021. So we are going to end the video here today. I just need to come on here and tell you some better reasons why you should consider moving to Ghana if you are considering moving back to Africa from the diaspora, and you are deciding which country to pick, you know, of all of the African countries. You should definitely consider Ghana. Come here and develop the country, and let's build a working country together. So let's end the video here. As always, before you go, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, to give the video a big thumbs up, and comment also, guys. Tell me all of your honest opinion in the comment section. And before you go, check my channel also, and also check my IG page out, where I say accessories, I say glasses. Just, you have it on the screen. Be sure to check all of that out, and I have a link in the description below also. So till the next time, guys, bye.